Let us try to solve our 1D model for two-phase flow. Capillary diffusion is usually small, so let us see what happens if we neglect it altogether. The advantage is that we can use a similarity transformation to solve our PDE. However, there will be a catch, as you will see at the end of this video. So, what's our problem? We have our conservation law, phi porosity times ds w dt plus constant u injection times dfw dsw times dsw dx equals zero, where this fw is given in terms of sw. Furthermore, we have our injection condition, the boundary condition we inject with sw equals one, and initial condition is conate water saturation. Now, we can try to solve this problem analytically in the following way. We can use a similarity transformation, eta equals x divided by t, and try to express all our variables in terms of eta. So that means if we take the derivative dsw dx, see the sw as function of eta, that becomes then the dsw d eta times d eta dx. Well, eta equals x over t, so partial derivative of eta with respect to x yields a 1 over t. So the dsw dx becomes a 1 over t times dsw d eta. Similarly, for the dsw dt becomes dsw d eta times d eta dt, and eta equals x times t to the power minus 1, so d eta dt becomes x times minus 1 t to the power minus 2, as we see over here. Then we plug this in into our PDE over here, and we will get an ODE in terms of eta, here the dsw dt, the dsw dx, because you can multiply with t, and then you are left with a minus x over t squared over here, which is exactly an additional eta. So we can factor out the dsw d eta, and we get the ODE minus 5 times eta plus u inject times dfw dsw times dsw d eta equals 0. So with two solutions, this can be 0, dsw d eta equals 0, so it yields a constant state. But with a constant state, we cannot connect the one injection condition to the conate initial condition. Or here, the solution over here, this can also be 0, that yields eta equals u inject over 5 times dfw dsw, which is a so-called rarefaction wave. Notice that this yields eta in terms of sw. So if you know your sw, this equation gives you your eta. We like to have it the other way around. Well, we can make that. If you plot, for example, f dsw on the y-axis and sw on the x-axis, we can find, by inverting this, our eta in terms of sw. Note that we took u inject over phi over here as 1, to simplify it a bit. So, what do we need to do? Well, this has to be our eta, and this is our sw, so we just flip the whole figure. That's what we did over here. So now we have an eta on the x-axis and sw on the y-axis. But now a problem arises. We start over here with injection 1, and then you say, well, we can just follow the curve. So if eta continues, sw becomes smaller. But hey, wait a minute. We have for every eta, not 1, but two values of sw here as well. So, how is this possible? What should we do if we would continue? We would go back. So this is obviously not possible. At one value of eta, you can have only one possible saturation. So, we have a problem here. So we are not done yet, because we have to solve this issue of multivaluedness. But we have a start with our rarefaction wave.